We didn't go into bodybuilding thinking about what bodybuilding can do for us. It was like what we can do for bodybuilding, what we can bring to bodybuilding that nobody else brought yet, physically or even on stage or even emotionally, even human spirit wise, you know? The gym was important, yeah. And putting it together in the gym, yeah. But the stage was extremely meaningful. It was more about an expression of who I was through my art of bodybuilding. Posing was learning how to be a star. Art affects human life. Bodybuilding is nothing less, it's an art. Creativity is the highest level of existence, in my opinion. Being creative is the closest thing to God. Everyone's a soldier. Everyone's a soldier following somebody else's so-called process or game plan, following the leader. We were leaders back in the old days. We were groomed and meant to be leaders. We weren't robots following somebody else. That's what old champions brought to bodybuilding. You have to know how to stand, you have to know how to walk. But I think you have to pay attention to a tight waist. You have to pay attention to presentation. You have to pay attention to posing. Nobody brings the energy to the stage. Nobody brings the human spirit to the stage. Nobody gives that to the audience and the judges. You gotta understand the stage more than you understand the gym. There's no energy coming from the soul on stage anymore. Watch Samir on stage. Watch Zane on stage. Look at the way they used to pose. Thank you. mean, the camaraderie, old school camaraderie, you know, it's not there anymore. In the old days, we were all training together. Everybody wore tank tops or, you know, muscles were showing and everybody was getting ready for their show. And in that kind of environment, I mean, everybody was very supportive. There was no money in it yet, but everybody was very supportive and everybody was very encouraging of everybody else. And everybody expected to win. And I'm not there alone. You're there with me. I'm there with you. We're in this together. We didn't know it was the golden era. We just knew, hey, it was this little place called Gold's Gym. Arnold was the star. When I got in there, we were the stars. Robbie Robinson, Frank Zane, Ed Corney, Ken Waller. I mean, we were the stars. People came to see us. But I would watch Robbie go from exercise to exercise. It was like watching a Black Panther. Robbie would never talk. He's the Black Prince. He was in the shadows. He didn't talk to people. He is something animalistic, something magical about him. Zane would come in and do one set of sit-ups for an hour. It wasn't about the drugs. It was about training, attitude, and energy in the gym, and just making it happen. The love of the game, the posing part of it. That's the reason I'm old school. Bodybuilding gave me life. It taught me about, you know, how to work, how to get up, how to live, how to fail. It taught me about friendship, camaraderie, the love of the game. I gained more friends than ever. You know, bodybuilding is about abundance and prosperity. It's not about pain, deprivation, punishment, and self-sacrifice. It's bodybuilding makes your life better. It's not your life completely.